If you want to create immersive XR experiences, you have to allow the users to feel the interaction. And the best way to do it is by using haptic feedback. Meta has come up with some awesome and powerful tools like the Haptic Studio and the Haptics SDK that allows us to create, design, and integrate immersive haptic effect inside our experiences. And do you know what's the best part? You can design or create your haptic effect once and use it not just for the Quest devices, but also for other PCVR devices out there like HTC Vive or Valve Index. Now, why is this cross-platform compatibility so important? Because when we develop an experience, we would like to publish it on different platforms like Meta Horizon Store and Steam without having to redevelop the whole experience. Now, you might be wondering, how does all this cross-platform stuff work, right? Well, for starters, the Haptic Studio allows you to export the file based on your target platform. And on top of that, the Haptics SDK takes care of finding out which controller is being used. Is it a Quest 2 controller, a Quest 3 controller, or any other PCVR controllers, and place the haptics accordingly, making sure that it works seamlessly across all controller types. But yes, you will have to make small changes to your project settings before building it onto the respective platforms. So in today's video, we'll see how we can design the haptics and integrate them inside Unity. We'll see how you can build for both the Quest devices and other PCVR headset. And finally, we'll see how you can export your haptic file for other standalone devices like Pico and PlayStation VR. Now, this might seem a lot, but trust me, it is really, really simple. Now, before we get started, I'd like to thank Meta for sponsoring this video and for their support. Alright, the first tool that we need is the Haptic Studio. Head to the link provided in the description below, scroll down and click on the link based on your computer's OS and download the software. Once you have it downloaded, install the software and run the Haptic Studio. Next, to test the haptic effect, we need to install a companion app on our Quest and pair it with the Haptic Studio on our computer. For pairing to be successful, you need to make sure that both your computer and your headset are connected to the same Wi-Fi. Then, put on your headset, go to the store, search for Meta Haptic Studio, and install this app. Boot the application, click on connect, and here you will be able to see a pairing code which you'll have to enter, and then you're all set. Now, before we start designing haptics, it's important for you to know the three ways in which you can control the vibration. First is the amplitude, which is nothing but the strength of vibration over time. Its value ranges from 0 to 1, with 1 being the highest. Think of this like adjusting the volume of a speaker. You can make the vibration go louder or softer by changing its amplitude. Second is the frequency, which determines the speed of vibration over time. Its value ranges from 0 to 1, with 1 being the highest. Think of this like adjusting the pitch of a sound. You can make the vibrations go faster or slower by adjusting its frequency. This parameter gives you a significant power to change the texture or feel of the haptic effect. A quick note here, Quest 2 and other PCVR device users will not be able to feel the change in frequency. And that's because the actuators in those controllers are different when compared to the ones inside Quest Pro, Quest 3 or 3S. The final parameter is emphasis, which is a short and momentary haptic feedback. While the other parameters control continuous vibration, emphasis lasts for only a tenth of a second. Its value also ranges from 0 to 1, with 1 being the highest. Alright, so now that you know the basic concepts, let's see how to implement them inside Haptic Studio. Since most of the haptic design is paired with or inspired by sound effects, bringing in audio files inside the studio speeds up the design process. So here I have a folder with all the audio files, especially those for which I want to create haptic feedback. You can also download this from the link in the description below, or feel free to use your own. And now all we have to do is select all these audio files, drag and drop it inside Haptic Studio, and the software will do its magic. It will generate all these haptic files after analyzing the audio. Now, to test the haptics, make sure that your device is connected. Then put on your headset, select the current project, and from here you can select the haptic clip and play them. Most of the times the haptic generated by the software can be used as is. However, if you want to fine-tune your design or edit them, you can do so by changing these sliders over here, or you can move the points manually like this. Now, we have covered what each of these parameters does and how you can change the amplitude and frequency in different ways in a separate video, which you can check it out over here. Now, once you're satisfied with your design, you can select all the clips, and export it. It's here that you get to choose the format in which you want to export your haptic design based on the platform. You can use .haptics for the Quest and other PCVR devices along with Haptic SDK. You can use .ahap for iOS integration, and you can use Waveform for other platforms that support it like PlayStation VR or Pico. Now, since we are targeting Quest and other PCVR devices, we can select .haptics, click on export, select your file location and click on save. And here you'll see all the haptic files. Alright, now let's see how to integrate this inside our Unity project. Let's start by creating a new project. Here you can use any editor version about 2021.3. I'm using 3D Core Render Pipeline. Let's give our project a name and create the project. Once you have your Unity project open, we can import the required packages by going to the Unity's Asset Store, search for MetaXR All-in-One SDK, open this inside the Unity editor, and install the package. Once that's done, you'll see that it has installed the latest version of the Haptics SDK along with some of the other SDKs that you might want to use later on. The next package that we need is the XR plugin management, which you can get by navigating inside Unity registry, scroll all the way down, select the package and install it. Alright, so with that we have all the required packages. Next, let's see how to set up our project. Now, since the Haptics SDK allows for cross-platform integration, we'll first see how to set up our project for the Quest standalone devices, set up our scene, build and test it on our Quest 3, then we'll come back and set up our project for PCVR devices, make small changes to the existing scene, and build and test it on our HTC Vive. So, to set it up for Quest standalone, navigate inside File, Build Settings, select Android and switch the platform. Then navigate inside Player Settings, XR Plugin Management and select Oculus as the plugin provider. Next, navigate inside MetaXR and here it will give you a list of issues which you can fix by clicking on Fix All. And it'll also give you a list of recommended settings which you can apply by clicking on Apply All. So with that, we have our project set up. Next, let's see how to set up our scene. First, select the main camera and delete it. Then right-click on your hierarchy, navigate inside Interaction SDK and add OVR Interaction Rig. Now this prefab comes along with all the components to track our headset, to track our controllers and even read the input values from them. Next, download this package from the link below and import it into Unity. This package comes with the Haptic Player UI, which is nothing but a template that you can use to assign these buttons to perform some actions. Next, to integrate the haptics, we need to write a script. So create a new C# script. Call it as Haptics Demo, open it up and I will see you in Visual Studio. First, let's define a serializable struct called as Haptic and Audio, which has two variables, one to store the audio clip and the other to store the haptic clip. Then, let's get rid of this code here and declare some of the variables to store a list of haptic and audio clips, reference the audio source and reference the text mesh pro text to display the haptic clip's name. Then, we can declare some more variables to reference the haptic clip player to see the current clip, the total number of clips and two bool values to see on which controller we have to play the haptics on. Next, let's define a method called player setup which takes in an integer value, and based on the integer value it's going to extract the audio and haptic clip from this list, and then it's going to reference the clip name, it's going to reference the audio source, and if we are calling the player setup for the first time then we want to create a haptic clip player and assign the clip. If not, we just want to assign the clip. Next, we want to create a play method to play the audio source and the haptic clip based on the choice of controllers. Similarly, we write functions to stop, play the next one, and the previous audio and haptic clips. Then we write two more methods to toggle the controller preference. And finally, in the start method, we can find the total number of clips and set up our player. And now you can save the script and go back to Unity. Alright, so here we are back in Unity. Now we can add this to our scene and create an empty object, call it as Haptics Demo, and add the Haptics Demo script to it. Then import the audio and haptic files inside Unity. Select Haptics Demo. Create a few elements inside this list, and in here you can assign the audio and the haptic clip. Once you have the audio and the respective haptic clip assigned, we can add an audio source and reference it over here. And now to reference the haptic clip player name, you can navigate inside Haptic Player UI button shelf, select the title and drag and drop it in here. Now let's assign functions to these buttons to allow us to play the haptic clip, play the next one, the previous one, or stop the haptic clip. We'll also assign functions to play it either on a left controller, right controller, or both the controllers. So to do it, navigate inside buttons, select all of these, scroll down and add an event to the list Then select Haptic Demo, drag and drop it in here. Now select each of the button individually and from the drop down select Haptics Demo and assign the respective function. Then navigate inside this button, select left controller, right controller, add an event to the list, drag and drop Haptic Demo, select left controller and from the drop down navigate inside Haptics Demo and select toggle left controller. Similarly, select right controller and from the drop down select toggle right controller. Now to make sure that you can interact with this canvas, right click on your hierarchy, navigate inside UI and add event system, then click on add components and add the pointable canvas module. And that's about it. Now to build and test this on your headset, make sure that your device is connected to your computer, then navigate inside file, build settings, add the open scene, click on build and run, create a new folder called as builds, give your APK a name and click on save. So the app has been successfully built onto my headset. Let's test it by pressing the play button. I'm able to feel the haptics on both my controllers and now I'm going to toggle just the right controller, play the next clip. And yes, I can feel the haptics only on my right controller. Now this is something that you'll have to try and it's really amazing to see how well the audio and the haptic files are synced together. Now as promised, let's see how to set up this project for PCVR devices. First, navigate inside Windows, Package Manager. From the drop-down, select Unity Registry and scroll down till you find OpenXR plugin and remove it. And instead, we can select the OpenXR plugin and install this package. Now, while installing, you'll get a pop-up asking if you want to enable the MetaXR feature set. Click on Cancel. Once that's done, you can navigate inside File, Build Settings, select Windows as the platform and switch the platform. Then navigate inside Player Settings, XR Plugin Management and select OpenXR as the plugin provider. Next, select OpenXR and add some of the interaction profiles like Oculus Touch Controller Profile, Meta Quest Touch Pro Controller Profile, HTC Vive Controller Profile and Valve Index Controller Profile. Then if you go inside the Project Validation tool, here it will show you some of the recommended settings and issues which you can fix by clicking on Fix All. So with that, we have set up our project for PCVR. Now moving on to the scene setup, to make sure that we receive input from the other PCVR controllers correctly, we need to replace the OVR camera rig interaction with XR Origin. And to do that, you can select this prefab, delete it, right click on your hierarchy, navigate inside Interaction SDK and add Unity XR interaction rig. Alright, as you can see, I have a successful PCVR build and I'm able to run it on my HTC Vive using Steam VR. My headset is tracked, my controllers are tracked, and now to see if the haptics work, let's click on the play button. And yes, I can feel the haptics on both my controllers. Let's try playing it on just my left controller. Yeah, there you go. Now, like I said before, since these controllers have different actuators, I'm not able to feel the change in frequency, but I am able to feel the change in amplitude. Now, that was super easy, right? What if I tell you this was just the beginning? In the next video, we'll see how to use the Haptics SDK along with the Interaction SDK and build this mini game. Make sure to like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one.